Hello designers and welcome back to another Affinity Designer tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how to create a takeaway coffee cup. Let's get into it. Okay, let's get started. So the first thing I want to do is see where the center of my document is. And in order to do that, we need a guide. So to get a guide, head over to the left-hand side where this kind of ruler is with the measurements and just click and drag out and a guide magically appears. So how do I find the center of my document? Well, right now it's very difficult. What we need is snapping. So if we head on up to snapping and we just select that. If you're wondering what some of my selections are, the options ticked, there they are. Okay, let's grab our guide and try again. So now I go to the center and there it is. It's locked into place. It snaps into place like a magnet. Okay, so our guide is in place now. Time to create a shape. So the first shape you're going to want is head on over here to the left-hand side and just click on the shape that has the drop-down arrow. That means there's more goodies inside. And just click on the trapezoid tool. So now that's selected, I'll just click and drag out a kind of shape that looks like this. And I've chosen this shape because it looks like a coffee cup, except it's upside down. So click on V, which is the move tool. That's your black arrow there, and just drag it to about here. I'm going to change the color of it because right now it's probably quite hard for you to see on such a white background. We're going to play around with colors more later, but for now we're just going to choose something that you can see. So we're on the color tab and this is our fill. This is what we're going to need to change. So I'll just select a color like this. Maybe something like that. So we don't want any stroke. You see there's the donut shape there. That is our stroke, our outline. We don't want that. Okay, our first shape is done and it's snapping to the center with our guide, which is great. So I want to flip that upside down. Quick way to do that is just head up to transform. Click on flip vertical. Okay, it's flipped vertically. It looks a little bit thick at the top there and a bit skinny at the bottom. So I want to change that. So the first thing we're going to do is click on the node tool and that will give us more options. So I've got the node tool selected and because we use the trapezoid, it's giving us these options. See these two little dots at the bottom here? If we hold down command, click and drag, it will drag out equally both sides like that. Okay, it's still looking a bit wide. So what I'm going to do is just hold down command, click and drag from the side there. Maybe something like this. Okay, I'm happy with that shape. So the next thing I'm going to do is create a lid. So I'm going to head over to the trapezoid tool again, click on it. And this time I'm going to start from the center of the document. You see the snapping is kicking in there. And I'm going to hold down command, click, and I'm going to drag out like that. Okay, now press on V, which is the move tool. That's the shortcut. Any shortcut I talk about can be seen. See the node tool is A, the move tool is V. They're all there for you. So you can kind of get that into your memory and make everything quicker. Okay, so I'm going to click and drag this down until it snaps into place. And again, I'm going to press on the node tool so that we can play around with these red nodes here. So again, I'm going to press command, click and drag out. Yeah, I'd say to about there. And I'll just zoom in and play around with it slightly so I can get the right kind of look. Let's make this black. So up to the color tab again, and I will just drag until it goes to black. Okay, now we need the other part. You know, usually on coffee cups, there is a bit that you drink from and it comes up a little higher. So what I'm going to do is duplicate this shape. So I'll press V, the move tool again, so we can select our shape. And I'm just going to press shift, command, I'm holding both of those down. I'm going to click and drag up and that's created a duplicate and I'll let go. I'll just drag it down until it snaps into place there. And again, from the side, I'll hold command, click and drag it in till about here, I think. And I'll make this a lot thicker, maybe that. Okay, so we have our lid and our container. Let's add a sleeve to this. So in the layers panel, you can see all of the layers that we've made. Let's create another one. So from this container here, I'm going to press Command C, Command V. And that's the copy and paste. You can also use Command J. So now I have two of those container layers there. And I'm just going to call this one Sleeve. And I'm going to change it to the blue color. And you'll see why now. So I want to make this a little bit wider because it comes out more than the coffee cup, doesn't it? But I can't see what's going on behind. So how do I see what's going on behind? Well, if I head up to opacity up here, and I just drag this down slightly until I can see what's going on. So I don't want it to have this much of a gap. I just want it to be a little bit less. So I'll hold the side again, press Command, click, and drag in till it's about there will do. If snapping annoys you, you can just head up to snapping and turn it off if you wanted to bring it any closer. So now we have this really big sleeve and we want to cut it down. How do I do that? Well, I use the knife tool. So head on up to the knife tool. The shortcut for that one is K. And initially, when you just click and drag, it will kind of be wonky however you are moving your finger along the trackpad or what have you. I don't want that, so I'm going to press Command Z to go back a step. Here's the trick. If you hold down Shift, click, and drag, even if you go up and down slightly, it won't move. So that's a very perfect straight line there. I'll let go, and it's made a cut. If you look in the Layers panel, there's two layers that say Sleeve now, because it's been cut into two. Let's do one more cut. So I'll press Shift, hold down Shift, click, drag, and now I've cut it in three. So I'll press V, the Move tool, and I'll just select the ones we don't want and press Delete. And the bottom one, we don't need that, Delete. And for the leftover sleeve, we're going to go back to Opacity, drag it up, and we'll just change the color again. So I'll just make this slightly darker. So we want to make this coffee cup an actual white color, because that's what color they usually are, depending on where you shop. But anyway, let's create the classic white one. So in order to do that, I need something in the background. So I'm just going to zoom out and I'm going to go ahead and grab my rectangle tool. I'm going to click on that. And I'm just going to click and drag out like this until it totally covers my design. And I'll just press V, the Move tool, and I'll just center it like that. It snaps into the center. So obviously it's covering our design. Now there's a number of ways you can do this. I'm not going to go through the whole ways, but just so you get used to the layers panel, that square that we've created is at the top. We want it at the bottom. So you can literally just grab it and drag it down and let go. And now it's underneath. Let's change the color of this. So let's zoom in and change the color to a very light color. Okay, now let's click on the container and change it to white. So that's our basic coffee container. If we wanted to add more, I guess, more realism to it, we could start playing around with the gradient tool. So let's go ahead and do that now. So again, with the coffee cup, let's head over and grab our gradient tool. Click on that. The shortcut is G, by the way. So I'll just click from about here and drag across. If you want to keep it in a straight line, just hold down Shift and then just drag until you're happy and let go. So now you can see it's going darker on the right-hand side and lighter on the left-hand side. What I'm going to do is just show you how that works. So I'm going to press G, the gradient tool again. On the left, there's a color, and on the right, there's a color. And each one that you select, you can head up to the color tab and change that. So there's the darker side. I can make that even darker. And same with the white side, I can change the color of that. Also in the center here, in fact, I will get rid of this guide now. So I'll just press V, the Move tool, because I don't need this anymore. And I'll just double tap. And then this guide thing will come up. The one selected is the one I just double tapped on. And I'll just press on the bin icon. And I'll press close. Back to the coffee container. I'll press G again. So this is the bit I was trying to show you before. There's a center line there, which we can also click and drag. And it has that effect. So if I just make it go to about here, and on this coffee cup, I don't want it to be super white. I'll just make it a little bit gray like that. So I'm happy with that for now. And I want to apply a similar kind of gradient up here because this is plastic usually, isn't it? So what I'm going to do is just click and drag across to apply it here. And in fact, on this one, I'll make it lighter on the right-hand side. So I'm just going to, on the color tab, I'm going to bring that up slightly. And it looks like it's a little bit too much. Something else you can do is you can actually just click on the line and add another point. So for this point, we can also make it black. So we can shorten that length. And you see we have loads of these midlines now. So I could just grab it and place it about here. And maybe on the right hand side, we can do the same. So I can make this slightly lighter on this side and just drag that out slightly. Okay, great. So what would happen if we wanted to copy this gradient onto this section up here, the top part of the lid, without having to go through that process again? Well, I could just click and drag out and do it all over again, but I'm just going to show you a shortcut. So I'm going to press Command Z to go back a step. I'm going to press on V, the Move tool. So with that part selected that we want to apply it to, I'm going to head down to Style Picker. I'm going to click on that. And then with the Style Picker, I'm going to select the gradient that I want to apply. So I've clicked on it and you see now it has applied it to the top part. So I'll press on V, the Move tool again. And that looks good from up here. But I kind of want to change this one now. So press on G, the gradient tool. And what we're going to do this time as well is just going to add another little bit of light here, just a tiny bit. So I'll just make it, yeah, about like that. But I want to add some more detail to the actual cup. So I'll press on V, the Move tool, and I want to add some kind of shadow underneath here. So what I'm going to do is this. I'm going to click on the rectangle tool on the left-hand side, and I'm just going to click and drag out like this, and I'm going to make it black. So right now, click on the Move tool, right now it's laying over the cup, and I want this shadow to be inside the cup. So how do I do that? Well, I'll just leave it here for now. If you head on over to the Layers panel and you click and drag it down and on top of the cup, you see it's being clipped inside there. So I let go and now that's clipped inside, which is kind of cool. So I'll just drag this up to about here. And now what we're going to do is apply a layer effect. We'll head down as it's still selected to the FX button here, Layer Effects. I'm going to click on that and now we have these options. I'm going to choose Gaussian blur. So I'm going to select that and I'm going to drag up the radius until I'm happy. So that shadow is looking pretty good as it is there. I will just click on scale with object and that will help me if I'm going to scale the object up and down. It's going to keep the same amount of blur. So I'll press close on that. It's a bit dark right now, isn't it? So what I'm going to do is head on over to the opacity under the layers. I'm just going to drag this down slightly until I'm kind of happy with it. Okay, that looks good. Maybe a little bit too dark. If I wanted to select that again, I could just double tap and then just drag it up slightly and bring opacity down a little bit. There we go. So let's play around with this sleeve and add something to here as well. So I'll just press G again, click and drag out like that. And it kind of chooses a color for you. See on this side, it's a bit too saturated for my liking. I'm just going to click on that. I'm going to head up to the picker tool. I'm going to click on it and drag it across because I want it to be the same as this side. And I'll just head up and click this little button here. So it's exactly the same. Now I'll click near the center there. And I'll just make this a little bit lighter. And I'll drag it off to the side there. And I'll just bring down the saturation of both of these sides. And same with the other side. Okay, something like that. So now we have our coffee cup. We've added a little bit of shadow to it, some contrast from light to dark, and you can go wild on this and add as much detail as you want. But one of the things that I like adding to these coffee cups is just a little hint of reflection to the lid because they're like hard plastic, right? What we're going to do is zoom in and we're going to click on the pen tool and we're going to click one point there. We're going to hold down shift so we go in a straight line and I'm going to click once more. Okay, so now we need to choose our stroke. So let's head up to the color tab. Let's get rid of the fill, so delete that. We'll click on the stroke and we'll just make it completely white. So it's just a thin white line at the moment. If we increase the stroke size, the width up to about here, I'm happy with that. So let's just zoom in a little bit more so you can see. So it's a perfectly straight line. Okay, here's a little trick. If we head down to pressure under the stroke tab and we click once in the middle there, And then we just click on the left-hand side and just drag it down. You can see what's happening on the left-hand side. It's getting skinny on the sides and it's keeping the thickness in the middle. That's what we want. So now I'll press on the move tool again up here. And I will just drag that up like so. And I'll just drag it out a little bit. So this is fine for me, but it's going over the coffee cup. So again, we're going to clip this inside of the top of the lid. So there's the top of our lid in the layers panel. I'll just name it so you can see. And this is our reflection. So I'm going to drag the reflection onto the top lid and let go. And now you can see when we go in, it's not going over the lid anymore. It's being clipped inside. So that's great. So what we're going to do now, we're going to copy that. So Command C on that one. We're going to go down to that bottom lid. And I'm just going to select it and press Command V and it will place it there in the layers panel and just drag it down again. So now it will be clipped inside of this shape, you see? So I will drag this over here. So if we zoom out, we can see it's looking pretty cool. And let's just change the color of the background so we can see what it looks like on a different colored background. Let's choose a dark gray. Yeah, it's looking much better now. So you can continue to add on to this to make it more realistic as much as you want. Obviously, it's just straight dead on. You can always play around with it even further. And I'll just do one last thing. So right now, it's still a trapezoid, the container. I'm going to head up to Convert to Curves. I'm going to click on that. And now we can see these nodes and we can play around with these. So I'm just going to click and drag that down slightly. I'll just zoom out to see how it looks. It's a bit sharp on the sides there. So what I'll do, I will grab a guide. Let's use guide to our advantage a little bit more. I'll just click and drag this handle to about there. And then using this guide, I'll do the same for this side as well. And you see the guide is helping me snap these handles in place to about there. That looks okay. And I can just do the same with this one as well. So if I head to our node tool again, and I just click and drag down just a little bit. So that is the coffee cup complete. If you wanted to add a little bit of texture to the sleeve, it might not be too obvious, but if you head up to opacity there in the color tab and you just click switch, you see this noise thing appears and you can just click and drag that up. And you see if I click and drag it up totally, you get this texture, which is a bit too much. If I just drag it down slightly, kind of looks like a bit of cardboard texture there, doesn't it? Okay, let's leave it there for now. Thank you for watching, and I hope to catch you again on the next tutorial. Ciao for now.